Hi, Rob at Atomic Tops here, and today I'm doing something which has taken many months to show, but I'm going to show a couple of results that I've got to. I'm not fully done yet, but it's taking too long, and I need to start showing people what it is I'm doing. I'm only going to show one type of design in two versions here today. I have seven, I forgot another one. I just made one last night. And so I'm showing one design in two versions. This has been a progression. I'm going to make a video of the progression that I've gone over for the last 5 months developing these things, and it's quite a story. I mean, I have a lot of prototypes and a lot of designs, and I've learned how to use a CAD program in the meantime, and all sorts of things have gone on. It's a very interesting story, actually. Make sure that's in focus. Okay. But I want to show people, because some people have been following me, and it's about time they start to see what it is I've been doing. Now, these quads are not particularly unique in the sense that they are a quad, but they have some features in them which are interesting. One of the main reasons I'm putting this video out is because I saw the other day another spinner that has the same idea as mine. Not the same design, but the same construction of plated, a concept to hold the bearing in. So I am using plates. A plate being that it's a sandwich, is three parts to it. There's a body and there's either one or two plates on either side, depending on how it's made. So one of the first quads I made was this one here. This originally is white, but I wanted to show how you can dye these. So I dyed this blue, and it has no bearing in it right now. We're buttons. I made buttons for them, all sorts of things. Like, I'll show you a button. Here's some of the buttons that I made. They just go on there like that. I can't spin it, obviously, because that has no bearing in it. But it worked really, really well, like this. And it was a unique design in the sense that it has a little shroud. If you can see this little cover here, let me focus that. Maybe it doesn't want to focus. Anyways, I don't know if you can see that, but it has this little shroud here. So when you put the button in, the bearing is, it goes down inside. The button was meant to fit inside this. Now, this button is not the one for this, but sorry, that's a bit confusing. There's smaller buttons like on this one here, actually. These are 17 mil buttons, and that was meant to fit inside there so that it would keep dirt from getting in and out. Lots of little innovations like that. This is a nylon SLS printed or additive manufacturing, they call it, and I have these what are called interscrews or sex screws or Chicago bolts for weight. That was one of my first designs, but I didn't like that you have to glue things. I didn't want to glue my stuff in or use a grub screw or other systems. So I went from there to lots of, I had so many ideas. Then I thought, why not make something that holds them in with a plate? So, but in the meantime, I'd made this one. Now, this one was just experiments again in coloring. You see, I've made a blue, that and a red. Now, this doesn't have the screws on the other side. I just haven't put them in. They're just stuck in on this side because the manufacturer made the holes the wrong size. But anyways, but it works really, really good. And I'll tell you what, this is such a cute little spinner. I mean, it really is. It's small. My hand looks big on this video. Very big. But it's just a cute little spinner. And I'll tell you what, it is such a pleasure to play with this. It really is. And it is just fun like anything. I can't say. But it only has a 17 mil button. I didn't like the button was a little small. So I made a larger button. I've made a 20 mil button. But these are nylon buttons too. All this. And you can see they have, there's ridges in there that fit inside the bearing and on top of the bearing. I have new versions of it. But this was really, really fun to play with. I like this one of my favorite, even though it's not, anyways, I went from that to this one. Now look at this. Isn't this beautiful? Look at that. These are my plated designs now. That's stainless steel, 316 stainless. This is not dyed. I mean, again, I can make that blue or green or red or black, different colors. And you can mix and match. You could have different colored buttons with different color bodies. And the stainless can be brass, so that could be titanium, which I have here now. That can be stainless, titanium. It could be any metal, you know, bronze or copper. This has even been updated. This design has now even been updated to include the ability to drop in weights into it, so you can even adjust the weight, and it spins really, really nice. So, but I made these ones. These are made for fidgeting, by the way. These are not made for how long can you spin something and go, you know, boom, and see how long it spins for. No, these are made for this. Boom, 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 back and forth, you know. That's what these are made for. They're made for fun, to spin, fidget with. And the quad is so nice as opposed to the tri ones. The quad is nice. Everywhere, your finger, when you have a two-arm one, the problem with the long two, there's so many things I could talk about. I've developed so many ideas, and I've studied so many spinners. But, you know, the bar ones, when you have that, like, for example, this. Okay, here's a Munson ring spinner. These bars, these long spaces, like when you have a bar spinner, like a torque bar, I'm not putting any other spinner down. Don't get me wrong. They're beautiful. I'm just saying, from a functional point of view, your finger has a long way to go before it gets to the next place it can push on. And that's why I designed another two-arm spinner with some a way to make it go faster. But that's another one I'll show in another video. But this is a Munson spinner. I'm even designing some buttons to go in there, and I might sell the rest of the Munsons I have. I still have about six of those, but I don't like them. But yeah, so the idea, and then I thought, well, the tri ones are nice, but why not make a quad? And so I've made a plated quad with, it has an internal places to put weights. So you can even adjust the weight. You can have the different colors. And I just think it's stunningly beautiful. Also, it really is. It's a little bit bigger than this one. It's a little bit bigger. I'm still calling it the mini compared to my large quad. But I just think it's just, if you like it, you don't like it, whatever. But you have to try and understand it with different colors. That could be black and blue. Black, you know, with the blue buttons. Or it could be blue with red buttons or whatever. And these buttons are sturdy, and they have a little depression, so your fingers, thumb or whatever fingers, these fit in there. And again, it's metal, and these hold the bearing in without, and you can just pop the bearing out. So if you want to change it, like if I comes with, say, a stainless steel 316 bearing, which is really good for corrosion, and you want to put in, say, a full ceramic or a hybrid or whatever, bang, just drop it in. So there you go. It's just really fun that I'll do it in slow motion like this. It's really fun. That's how I play with it. Or you can just, like, you know, spin it like that with your other finger. Or you can hold it in this one and do one of these. That's really fun. Just back and forth like this. I'll do it slowly so you can see it in the camera. But they're really, really good. So that's that one. Okay, now the last one I want to do is, I don't want the video to go too long. Really, I have so much to say about spinners right now. So much is in my head. You wouldn't believe how much I've gone through for 5 months doing this. But this one here is really special. It just looks like regular, but again, you try and imagine if it's colored. You can have these different colors. And this is a plate. I'm not going to take it apart right now. It'll take too long, but because I've also redesigned the inside to make it really cool. I tried something inside, making little tabs in, like, that were supposed to, by spring tension, hold it in, but that didn't work. I won't get into that right now because that was a failure big time. So I redesigned the whole thing for something that does work, because I already tried it with an earlier version with a metal, and it does work. So I use that now in the plastic. So I'm just going to decide which way to go. But these are plated also, but it's only plated on one side. On this side, it's molded in. This is all molded in as one piece. And then there's a platform, and the bearing just drops onto the platform. And then you put, this is a plate, which is molded perfectly into the, I don't know if you can see that. It you can see that sort of, it goes right in there. It goes all the way around inside. There's a little, it's like a crossy thing with plates there. And it goes right in there, and that holds the bearing in, but it also hides a lot of spaces to put weights into. So you can actually, the new version of this, which is getting it made this week, is it's really awesome. The new version I think is incredible. This was I thought was really cool too, but the system of holding it didn't work. So this new system will work, and it has the ability to really put a lot of different weights in it. So yeah, and then you can color it different colors. So you could have the plate could be like blue, and you could have like the housing could be red, or the other way around, or black and red and green, and you have green. And then the buttons can be different colors than the plate and the housing and the body, I mean. So it's really cool. And with the different, I mean, it really does spin nice. Look at this. And it's a bit bigger. You can see it's a bit bigger than the mini one. Well, the real mini one. I'm not going to be making those right now. I could do it, but I like these. These are so, so sweet. I really do like those. And this is just unique in a sense of design. It's really, but it spins nice. It's a little bit, right now, this is the old version, so you listen. You can hear it making, but this one is really quiet. See that? Nothing. But this one makes a bit of a noise, but that's because it's the nylon rubbing on the nylon a little bit because it's out of line. One of the things I used it to make it, it broke. So inside, it's a little bit off-center, and that's why. But that's fixed. The new version is that's fixed, and it has a better feature too. But this is a really, I mean, it's a nice size. I think they're about 70-something mil. And what, oh yeah, I want to go back just that one last bit. The bit about having the quad as opposed to the tri is, again, I'm trying to tighten up the space where that your finger has to land on to be able to get to the next, like, see here, look at how far it has to travel to try and get to something to hit to move it. And it's just not, it slides on these things, not nice. That's the problem with two-arm ones. Usually my two-arm one doesn't have that problem. You'll see why when I release them. But these quads, every time you, doesn't matter where your finger falls, it's ready to go for the next one. It's just ready to go. So there you go. That's 12 minutes long. I could honestly speak for a couple of hours on spinners because I've got so many things that I've worked on. But I've come a long, long way. And this time I've learned how to use a CAD program because I was charged quite a bit of money by a company to take my drawings and to make technical CAD drawings for the laser cutting. Now I'm going, these are laser cut. These are 3D SLS, laser sintered, selective laser sintering it's called, bodies with laser cut metal. I keep on saying, I'm sorry. But I'm going to water jet to see how the water jet goes. So I have some titanium, copper, not copper, brass, titanium, stainless steel, and I'm going to have these cut in water jet in the next week. So, but there you go. That is basically ready to go. The new ones will be anyways, and that's another version, and that's what I want to show today, would like to show you, and I hope that people think, I know they're just plastic ones, I have versions of these in metal, all metal, but what I can't do with metal right now is I can't put in all those little designs, because that would be milling, and the things would cost a lot of money. The metal ones are more straightforward, they're actually technically simpler than these are, but they're still nice, very nice. And also I have the tritium versions of they don't look like this at all. They do sort of look like these. I mean, they got arms, but they have different designs. I have tritium, so they'll glow. Two different, well, I have a metal version of tritium. I have a metal version of tritium, and I have also the plastic version of the tritiums. Again, these are not just cheap plastic. This is not just extruded plastic stuff. This is SLS laser made nylon, very strong. This stuff's very, this is not going to break. Very, very strong. And there's so much I could say about it, but there you, whoa, there goes the camera. Let's put that back together again. Okay. And that's really all I have to say. That's just some of the progression of the things I've made and where I've come to. These two are going to be production. The metal ones versions, I'll have a metal quad. I have a two-arm version, which is better than, I think, any other two-arm in function, not in maybe design, and looks, because, I mean, some people make some really nice spinners, really nice spinners, but I think mine are pretty cool. And these are the plastic versions, nylon, and yeah, so what else? That's about it, right? Tritium is there. Metal versions are there. two arm versions are there. Well, two arm and a bit. It's kind of nice. And the quads. All right. Not a professional video, I know. I do apologize. But it's what I can do with what I have. All the best. Let me know what you think. That's all I can say. Bye for now.